The views and comments expressed on the following radio program by its hosts and their guests do not necessarily reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
Good evening, everybody. Tonight, we celebrate artists whose music and message help shape our culture. And together, we can change our culture for the better by ending violence against women and girls. Right now, nearly one in five women in America has been a victim of rape or attempted rape. And more than one in four women has experienced some form of domestic violence. It's not okay, and it has to stop. Artists have a unique power to change minds and attitudes and get us thinking and talking about what matters. And all of us, in our own lives, have the power to set an example. Join our campaign to stop this violence. Go to itsonus.org and take the pledge. And to the artists at the Grammys tonight, I ask you to ask your fans to do it too. It's on us, all of us, to create a culture where violence isn't tolerated, where survivors are supported, and where all our young people, men and women, can go as far as their talents and their dreams will take them. Thanks.
Crispy M&Ms are back.
What are you doing?
You said to tell our fans Crispy M&Ms are back.
Not those fans.
Did you mean this fan?
No.
What about that one?
Hi.
There's a fan in the break room. Oh,
in so
the
good. Room. They're back.
Walker with the handle, takes it, puts it up, in, and a foul! Oh, ho, ho! That's how you get 30 points. Duncan for Mills, the pass got away. Andre to KCP to Brandon Jennings. Brandon drives it, puts it up, oh, fast, got it! The officials want to take a last second look.
He's telling them stay here.
But it looks to me like the Pistons have won the ball game over the third.
Second. Down to four. Three. Down to two. Hart puts it up. He got it! The Beard! Cold-blooded three to win the game. It's over. Cold-blooded shot for James Hart to win.
And hitting 66% of his shots. Over the last five, the Bucks pick it away. Yes! Thrills the crowd in the BMO Harris Bradley Center. I know you want to see that again.
Whoa!
You want to see it one more time?
Ring that bell. He can do it.
That's what his own the future move after
That's
that
right.
dunk.
He's got 37. Mo Williams has 42.
You got to get up to him early. And that's all you can see Rodney Stuck with his left.
Williams hits it.
I'm telling you, David West was right there.
52 tonight for Mo Williams. Booker. Got it. Are you kidding me? Grandma shot, that defines the phrase grandma shot.
I have never seen anything like that in a game, ever.
Can we see this again, please?
Look at this. He doesn't even touch it. He just volleyballs it up. It's almost like he's done it before. I know he's laughing because he can't believe it.
You know?
That is crazy.
What the heck?
Irving, ball is string. Inside. Finish your left hand. Right down. You could have won. Tires. For three. Oh, Kyrie Irving! Are you kidding me? A game for the ages! 11 triples!
Keep finding Klay Thompson to the rim again!
Klay Thompson, 24 points in the third. Thompson, three ball, right side. Got it! He's not human! A 27-point quarter!
Klay driving again! To him again. He's got it. His three. Got it! 35 in the quarter.
He has not missed a shot, period.
Well, if you're wondering what the NBA record is for most points in a quarter, you just watched it. Klay Thompson has 37 in a quarter. I'm going to repeat that. 37 in a quarter.
This is pure magic.
Word up.
Well, welcome to our show.
Now, everybody.
This is SNE Live. SNE Live with Mars and Marv.
It's sports and entertainment.
Parental discretion is advised.
Are you scared?
Streaming live for you at rmconair.com.
It's SNE Live.
It's SNE Live.
And it goes a little something like this.
Now here's Mars and Marv.
Welcome. It's Monday. Monday, February 16th. It's a good day, man.
Yes, sir. Always, brother.
Happy President's Day, man. Happy President's Day. Obama, man.
Obama, man. We had to do it. We had to do it. You feel me? Represent for our black president.
Yes, sir. Always. I love our president. He's my personal hero.
Absolutely. So. Absolutely. Absolutely. Hey, listen, man. We got good topics today, man. We're going to brief on a little bit of NBA, little recap, you know.
Yeah, the All-Star game, weekend.
Absolutely.
Man.
Woo! Pretty sick.
Russell Westbrook, man.
Man, he gets honors. He gets all the honors. He did his damn job out there.
Yeah, man. Balling out, 41 points, man. You know what I'm saying? 20, ooh, 27 ooh. And a half. Ooh. All the dunks, man. He was out of his mind, man. That dude was getting off.
He hit his head on the backboard on one of them dunks.
Man.
It's crazy.
Man, he was catching alley-oop, shooting three-pointers 4 feet behind the line. You know what I'm saying? He was just... He had the juice.
Hi, this is Andre.
The
Ward.
Juice.
What's up, y'all?
You know the juice is like, man, it's like having it.
Yeah.
You feel me?
In the zone.
And you know you can't have it unless you got it. It's like having that Movado, man. When you just walk on the court, man, and you just know you the fucking shit, man, and you go out there and actually play like that.
Yeah, you got to make that up in the locker room or before you even get to the game, though. You got to go out there and be like, you know what? I'm about to bring it tonight.
Right.
Ain't nobody stopping me. I'm going in tonight.
Well, you know what? Well, you know what I think it is with Russell Westbrook, and this is just my little humble opinion. You know, you play with Kevin Durant, so, you know, the MVP of the league, you know. So yeah, no matter what, you're going to be kind of in his shadow. You know, you can ball all you want. It's always going to be about Kevin Durant. So I think he wanted to take that opportunity amongst his peers, the best of the best, and show everybody in the nation who got game for real.
Well, Russell take them opportunities during the games.
Yeah, no, I know.
Sometimes.
Now, well, it so, don't always work out that way. Honestly, as a Spurs fan, I love when Russ gets full of himself because, you know, he makes mistakes. So I love it. But last night, he was making everything, balling out. Big ups to him on the MVP of the All-Star game. He almost caught Wilt Chamberlain's record of 42, you know, with 41 points. So, hey, hell of a performance.
Hey, according to Bleacher Report, they said he had a historical All-Star night. You know, it speaks for itself, man. When you got tabloids like that reporting about you, man, you know, you went out there and really took some numbers down.
Yeah. I don't think Russell is anybody's Robin, if you ask me. You know what I'm saying? I think the dude is a star in himself. And he just so happens to play with a guy who's kind of humble and likable more than his aggressive you know, nature that he carries around every day. So, you know, you want to, you know, give Durant all the, you know, accolades. But, you know, Russell is the heart of that team, if you ask me.
Well, I think Kevin is probably the most talented player. I know everybody talks about LeBron and being the best player in the world and all that. But my personal opinion, just on basketball, putting the ball in the hoop, I think Kevin Durant's the best in the world.
Yeah, but at the end of that playoff last year, he just falling on his face. I can't really say that.
Yeah, well,
you know, he wasn't doing too good. He didn't close out too good. He didn't close out like it's a fourth quarter guy. I'm gonna take over this. He kind of did not do that.
What I was getting ready to say was, with that being said, he's missing that moxie that Russell Westbrook got. That
very
that,
true.
That vicious, like, yo, undeniable, like, you won't deny me this. Yeah. Like, I'm coming to get it, and, like, I wish you would try to stop me. You know what I'm saying?
LeBron was a little passive early, too, but, you know, they got to get some Kobe in them. They got to start getting that killer Michael Jordan, Larry Bird, Magic Johnson. They could care less about it. They was going to cut your throat, and we'll talk about it later at the bar or something, but I'm going after it right now.
Definitely. So, you know, at the end of the day, you know, I think Russell Westbrook is, like you said, he's a star in his own right. He's going to bring it every chance he get. He ain't backing down from nobody. He feels he's the best player on any court. You know what I'm saying? So that's what you're supposed to feel like. You know, so, I mean, I wouldn't expect nothing less from you.
All-Star Weekend was a remarkable history-making event. Pours in 41 points to earn the Kia MVP honor.
163-150.
Don't get it twisted.
What you talking about? Hey, shout out to James Harden for hitting the big-time three-pointer. You know what I'm saying? That really kind of broke the game open. It was like 4 minutes and 38 seconds. He hit a three-pointer that kind of iced that game. You know what I'm saying?
And shout out to Steph Curry. Steph Curry was sick yesterday. I mean, he could have took the MVP as well.
Well, he won the three-point contest, and deservingly so. He hit like 19 in a row. My man was just straight water, as you say it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, he's my favorite, you know, NBA player. I actually met Steph Curry, you know what I'm saying, out here in Hollywood. You know, he's just a real humble dude, real cool cat, you know what I'm saying? So I always root for him. And now that he's turning into everything that he was in college, you know, because he was the best player in college, you know.
I mean, he do what he do.
Do what he do.
As far as up-and-coming dudes, I mean, if you was going to start a team, you had to look there. You couldn't just pass him.
Well, that's what I say. I mean, if I was going to start a team, we doing an NBA draft like today, everybody on the line, everybody's available. I'm probably, you know, you got to start with a point guard. So, you know, I'm always going with, point guard first. So I'm picking Steph Curry, man. But with that being said, I'm looking forward to seeing what the Warriors do in the second half of the season.
Well, Steve Kerr doing a great job,
doing
by the way.
Job.
I mean, there was a lot of hoopla about him. Should he have a job? Is he worth all this? And why is everybody chasing him around like he's la-la-la, Phil Jackson or somebody? Well, Phil Jackson's up there destroying the Knicks, and Kerr's down here.
Well, you can't say Phil destroying the Knicks. Knicks was destroyed when Phil got there.
I agree with that, but he ain't helping none.
Check this out.
Well, if they was on their way out, he'd been put their foot on his neck.
You can put
neck
sugar
now
on shit all you want, don't make it a ice cream sandwich.
Check this out. Next up, we will be talking a little bit more about sports, but we're going to go into some entertainment, talk a little bit about the NWA Straight Outta Compton, and it's coming to y'all as soon as possible.
Right after this break.
Welcome to Compton.
What up, man?
Okay, Dr. Dre.
Okay.
That's where it all started.
We put it all in the music, all our frustration and anger. Our music was like our weapon.
And that's the most powerful weapon we got.
What's up, man? What a lot of people don't realize about NWA is nonviolent protest.
We let people know that it's okay to say what you want to say. It's crazy to see how all these different people around the world feel the same way that we feel. We kicked the door down for a lot of artists.
Game time. What's up?
The foundation that was set by y'all, man, I'm so appreciative. You know, I just try to keep the flame lit.
What's up?
When I think of NWA, it wasn't really music to me. It was more like a real lifestyle. Brothers from my neighborhood that made it out.
The same thing that we was going through in the 80s with the police people going through right now.
It's a good time for us to tell our story. Be some kids from Compton, how we touched the world.
Let me tell you what I see here. A lot of raw talent. Swagger. Bro. bravado. People are scared of you guys. They think you're dangerous. But you have a unique voice. The world needs to hear it.
All right, let's hit this shit.
All right.
Spinning records ain't paying none of the bills around here.
What you talking about? I get paid.
$50, Andre. You think that makes you rich?
It's a start.
Hey, Q, what, you a poet now?
The flyest one you know, nigga.
You got them rocks? That hard shit.
You know that's all I do.
I got a cold ass beat.
That hardcore reality rap.
So what you talking about doing?
Cruising down the street in my 6'4".
Hey, that was dope, eh? That shit was dope, man.
You a genius.
What's NWA stand for anyway? No whites allowed? Something like that?
No. Niggas with attitudes.
Straight out of Compton. Crazy motherfucker named Ice Cube. From the gang called Niggas with Attitudes.
You have any idea how many records you're selling? NWA's arrived. You're fucking huge.
Dangerous motherfucker raising hell. And if I ever get got, I make bail. See, I don't give a fuck. That's the problem. I see a motherfucking cop out of the dodge.
Your songs, they glamorize gangs and drugs.
Our art is a reflection of our reality.
The Rodney King beating was a shocker.
Guys like you change shit like this.
This is a threat, guys, from the federal government.
Speak a little truth and people lose their minds.
The performance of the song, F the Police, will not be permitted.
They try to tell us what the fuck we can't play. This is NWA. Yo, Dre.
What up?
I got something to say.
Straight out of Compton.
Straight out of Compton. I'm looking forward to seeing that, man. That's going to be a joint right there.
I think that'll let a lot of people know a lot of stuff about what's going on in between things.
You know, my take on it is I think personally it's a good film, man. I think that it's necessary for the youngsters to know about NWA, know about the start of NWA. But the depicting of the gang and bringing that, it's kind of like roaring things back up to me.
A little bit. But you can't tell the story without telling the story. That's like doing the Whitney thing project and you don't include the drug abuse. I mean, it's going to have to come.
But don't you think that's fuel on the fire? Don't you think that creates like, a situation that for our kids, we talking about our kids here and our youth, it puts them in a compromising situation.
Man, look, this is how I feel about it. It's been a touchy situation for like going 20 years, 25 years strong. You know what I'm saying? So like,
I agree.
The fact that they're bringing all this up and making this movie, I definitely feel like it's going to touch some nerves, going to bring up some old skeletons and hurt feelings. So, I want to see the movie. I want to know what happened. I want to know all the backdrop with Easy and Dre. Because when you look at it, you have two people worth $1 billion that come out of this rap group. Dr. Dre and Ice Cube. Well, Ice Cube may not be worth $1 billion, but he's damn well on his way. He's up there. He's doing real good.
Everybody's doing pretty good.
Everybody's doing pretty good.
Even Snoop on the offspring of that.
Exactly.
And that's my point. My point is these guys is doing good. These guys is out the way. You feel me? These guys is out the way where they can even take their kids out the way. Their kids don't have to go to the urban center to go watch a movie. They don't have to go down to the Cineplex, or to the Bridge or to go watch a movie. You know what I'm saying? So the atmosphere, that they're going to go watch these movies. See, I remember when I was a kid, right?
Yeah.
And I remember when Boys in the Hood came out. My mom took me there, And I remember it was playing right on La Brea at Baldwin Hills Theater. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And she took me there, man. It was so many gangbangers there, and there's so much riffraff that happened that night prior to us going. And we went to a day film. This was a daytime viewing that we went to. You know what I mean? You're talking midday, 3 o'clock, and it was still drama popping off. So I'm just saying, like, for our kids, as L.A., it kind of died down. So bringing that film out, is it the right time to bring it out? I mean, are we doing it just for the money? Is it just a money thing? Or do we really care about our kids?
It's for the money. I won't say it's a money thing. Art. Everybody wants their story told. This is kind of it too, A lot of people don't want to wait till they dead to see their story. You know what I mean? Why not tell it while you living good and your life is good? A lot of people don't even get to see their own documentaries and stories done. You know, they wait and they wait and what time is a good time? And then, you know, you're gone. So somebody else is pretty much telling your story while you're not even around.
S&E Live with Mars and Marv. We're listening to S&E Live with Mars and Marv.
And let me jump in here. And this is my thing. How about this? Dr. Dre just signed a big deal with Apple. Matter of fact, he's on the CEO table, you know, board of, you know, directors or whatever, okay?
Yeah.
He just cashed out for, I think, $1.3 billion. Y'all don't think that got nothing to do with this movie coming out right now? You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah, I think it's always money. You know, this is a business. This is Hollywood. Everything's always about money.
Oh, of
but
course. You're
I
not
think the
make
story,
it
I think the story alone is worth a lot of money. It's worth telling. Because, like I said, when I revert back to it, look who came out of this rap group.
Yeah.
Look what this rap group did for West Coast hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? And hip-hop in general. They're the kings of gangster rap. Everything everybody's saying today, doing today, this was the group that really brought the West perspective on it. A lot of East Coast caps, you know, you had, you know, NWA talking that stuff. But on the West Coast, NWA was it.
Well, it seems like NWA was like the opposite side of Public Enemy with the same look but a
sure.
different tone and vocal.
Sure.
So it's this day, it is what it is. But look at it in the sense of some guys coming together, too. You know, a lot of these guys didn't really get along, you know. It was at some point that, you know, they were all beefing about, you know, remember calling each other names on records and
yeah,
Cube and
sure.
Dre and Benedict Arnold and, you know, Benedict Arnold and things like that. So a lot of stuff going on with this situation.
It's almost like, it's not to cut you off, but it's like a family feud.
Yeah, so if they come back together to do it and it's going to be beneficial to everybody, I think it's a good situation. I want to see it. You know, I want to see what happens so I can get more information because so many mysterious things were going on within that situation. Hopefully they can clear up some things that was going on and give us a better understanding of the whole NWA situation. Help
yeah,
us out a little bit.
Yeah, it need to be, you know, I don't know, man. I feel like a little situation about that, but you know, it is what it is, man. But next we gonna go into what's trending, and then we got MoPreme coming on, man. MoPreme is coming up next at MoPreme
Shakur. Thug life
is definitely in the building.
Yes, sir.
So we'll be back at y'all, man, in 2 minutes 2 seconds. All right,
yes sir,
peace.
Yeah, return of the outlaws.
Yeah
man, bring it back on them. How about that? Hey man, you know what? MoPreme, man, you know, it's the Thug Life thing, man. When that album dropped, man, it was so refreshing, man. It was refreshing, man, because you know that they was spitting like lyrical, but still like hood. You know what
yeah.
I mean? And you know, we did, it was the first time I really seen that, man. You know, on this side of the coast, man. So that was very refreshing.
Yeah, and it was a movement going on too at that time. You know, Pac was putting together some strong things.
Yeah, you know, Pac was at the height of his career at the time. You know what I'm saying? He had Thug Life. He had the Outlaws, you know, so they was doing it. He wrote a lot of the songs, you know, had a lot of creativity and input into that.
And speaking of Pac, Vegas, MGM,
yeah,
Pacquiao, Mayweather,
yeah,
what's going on,
man? That's...
ain't no fight happening.
What the fuck is going on?
Think about it. Oh. Common sense. Here we are. Today's February 16th, all right? If today's the 16th, you telling me a fight going down May 2nd?
No. No, I don't think
not
so.
A chance. Stop.
I don't.
So we know Mayweather fight in May and September. So unless he's fighting in September, which I doubt it, why would we be talking about it now? Because, you know, you'd want to talk about it months leading up to the fight, not 8 months before the fight.
I mean, the promoters done talked. They done talked personally. I mean, when is it really going to happen?
Man, and I got the 12-second clip of them talking Shaft.
Yes, sir.
I got them talking personally.
Let's see.
You know, I congratulate him on his career. He had a wonderful career, and I had a wonderful career. But before we leave the sport, of course, we have to make this fight happen.
Well, make it happen.
Right? Make it, man.
Well, can we get it on then?
Okay,
I mean,
you know what?
Really?
Hold up, time out. Now, we know why the fight ain't happening.
We know why the fight ain't happening.
I mean, at this point, I done heard a million excuses. I don't know which one is the real one at this point.
There's $1 billion on the line. Make the fight happen. If you want to make it happen, get Bob Arum out the way. We know y'all can't stand each other. We know y'all hate each other. But this ain't got nothing to you and Bob. This ain't got nothing. It's between you and Pacquiao. I'm not watching another Mayweather fight.
I don't even think it's between him and Pacquiao. Naturally, I think they hate each other. I think the two fighters actually really do not like each other.
Hate's a strong word, but I would say strongly dislike.
I think the managers don't like each other either.
Yes.
Now, when you get down to Al Haymon and these cats, man, you know, they real loyal when you talk about Mayweather and to the whole Al Haymon camp. And a lot of these new fighters, this is the kind of the politics of things, is because you have new promoters coming in the game. And Al Haymon he's strong-arming a lot of these old, because, you know, he is from the old regime. You know what I mean? He's from the, they did all the greats.
Old school. Right. And you know what old school means?
Well, you know what?
Don't expect a fair shot.
Right. Boxing is still about the promoters. It's still about, they run this business. And every fighter, they got all the fighters under their little umbrella. So you can't do nothing without them. It's like the NBAs and the owners. You know, it's like, you can get mad, you can say what you want, but the owners run the game. They paying the paychecks. And it's the same thing with these promoters. They setting up the fights, they're putting the fighters in place, they getting all the things, all the interest, all the things with Showtime and CBS and all that. So at the end of the day, if we could get the promoters out the way, which is why Mayweather is so rich, because he cut the middleman out.
And that's the hold up on the fight. Exactly. Do they want a brother man to get that much money that much power?
I'm not going there.
I'm
on
not
him.
Either.
I'm just saying.
You got to deal with what you got to deal with.
Well, I think Pacquiao's.
It's always that way when the situation ain't amongst two other people.
If it was up to Mayweather, the fight would happen. I think it's on Pacquiao's side.
Absolutely. I think so too. Me being a fan of Mayweather, I agree.
And that leads to what I said, do Pacquiao's side want to see Mayweather and them eat that much?
Right.
Hey, listen. He don't got a choice. He's trying to, not to cut you off, but he need that money.
That Pacquiao's doing all kinds of shit. Dancing in the street out there. Playing. I don't know what he's doing, but let's get it going.
On another note, Bobby Christina, man. Shouts out to Bobby Christina. She's still in the same situation. According to TMZ, we got exclusive intake about, you know, her organs shutting down and things of that nature. So we'll talk a little bit more about that and things like that. We're going to get to MoPreme.
MoPreme Shakur.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Still waiting to do that.
Yeah, it's still
can't wait.
And listen, check this out. We have a beautiful situation here that y'all don't even know about.
What's that, G?
Y'all don't even know, man, what's going on.
Tell your boy what's up, man. I'm trying to know what's up.
I'll let your boy.
I don't know. I got to go to my gritos, okay? I got my special guest here, okay? My name is Alpandro. Alpandro?
Alpandro.
Yeah, Alpandro. You guys ask me anything, okay? Ask me anything, okay? We're gonna do a little sketch right now. My name is Alpandro.
We want to know who would win that fight that we were just talking
who
about.
Who would win? I think Mayweather. I think Mayweather, because I'm a Mayweather fan, right? Yeah. Right? You know? But I think Pac-Man is good. He's a good guy.
Pac-Man.
Yeah. Pac-Man, he's a good guy, you know? So we're going to take it like that. This shit didn't fucking shit, man. Hey, listen. Thug Life. I rep Thug Life, man.
Do you?
You didn't know that?
Thug Life?
I rep right? Thug Life, man. I got it tatted on my stomach. You didn't know. That shit is fucking bomb, man. Listen, man. Listen, we're back at you, man. S&E Live with Mars and Marv.
And your boy, Shaft.
Holla at him.
The station with the best music. Best music.
I love the music.
I want to meet the man who whooped your ass. I want to meet who whooped Shaft's ass.
In your face.
That's what I want.
All over the place.
Which one is yours?
And I don't know. I'm going to put a 566 plus the edges of the emergency.
Yes, I need a, here you go, ma'am. Meet your teeth. I need the police up at the W Hotel in Midtown at 188 14th Street.
188, what's the street name?
It's up here. My name is Adam James.
Adam, what's your phone number?
My phone number is.
Can you say this is 188 14th Street?
Uh-huh.
Okay, and tell me what's going on there.
They're having a fight in the bar here. We have a group that's fighting in the bar, and they're not leaving.
Does anybody have any weapons?
No weapons.
Okay, they're fighting now?
They use one of the glasses at our bar as a weapon, though. They hit somebody and cut them in the face.
Okay, this is at Colony Square?
No, yeah, Colony Square.
How many people are in this dispute? How many people are fighting?
It's got to be like 8 or 10 people.
And they're in the bar?
Yeah.
Okay, we got the call. We'll go ahead and get someone out there.
Okay, thank you.
Uh-huh.
In the mix. In the mix. Back to back, beat to beat. Come on, DJ. Hit me with another track.
We live in direct S&E Live with Mars and Marv. S&E Live with Mars and Marv.
Sir, can we get MoPreme on the phone? Where MoPreme coming, man? That's what I want to know. Yeah. I'm excited and shit.
What it do?
What's up, boss? How you doing, boss?
Hanging tough, man. Hanging
yes, sir.
Tough.
Thanks for being on the show. This is Marv, man.
What's happening?
Yes, sir. And John Schaff, of course.
What's up, player?
What it do?
Hey, you know how we do it. So you was telling me about that little tour thing that y'all just did. How did that go? Tell me a little something about that.
Which tour? With the Outlaws show?
Yeah.
Oh, that was like one of the last European shows I did with them. It was me, Bone Thugs, Outlaws, Dub C, Nipsey Hussle.
Nice.
Yeah, we were out in Sweden and shit.
Yeah, how was it out there? They showing love out there?
Oh, yeah. It's cool because it's still like it's, you know, 96 out there. They still into the music, mm-hmm. which is refreshing, you know?
Yeah, we be killing ourselves, right?
Yeah, that's crazy, man. We just had, by the way, man, I'm Mars. How you doing, man?
What it do?
We just had Fredro Starr on the show. About a week ago, man, and he was saying the same thing, that they just got off a tour, man, and how the response is like 90, 96, 95, back again, you know, like they loving hip-hop, and it's just back that energy back again, man. So, you know, by you guys being old-school groups, man, and y'all coming from that era of things, how is hip-hop just changing per se in the States rather than overseas?
Well, the game has been changing and has changed significantly in different aspects.
Yeah.
Thank God, you know, I'm OG. I got in when I did, and I got a little name in the game. You know, I feel for the young cats coming up because it's harder. The game is saturated, and you're competing against the internet with no marketing dollars.
Yep.
So, you know, it's, you know, you can free to do your thing, but you got to make an impact on an instrument that's used by everybody in the world.
Yes, sir.
Literally.
Yes,
so,
sir.
You know, the game is really, you know, on some topsy-turvy shit. So, therefore, we have to adapt and overcome.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about, excuse me, not to cut you, how do you feel about the how we had so many different types of groups back then to just, like, just a few of the same type of styles now? Well, there was so much difference back then, variety of things.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you know, the game goes through cycles, music goes through cycles, and, you know, it's just the cycle that it's in. You know, it only appeals to most of the young cats because it's new, it's theirs, it's their shit, but, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Well, they used to say that to us, too.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So I'm trying not to be too judgmental, but I'm feeling a lot of it. So, you know, I try to stay in my lane unless I'm invited in.
Absolutely. Now, MoPreme, let me ask you this, because, you know, there's a lot of debate about hip-hop today with the difference of what it is today and what it used to be. So in your opinion, coming from the old school, the beginnings of hip-hop, who's the hottest rapper out today?
Oh, wow.
So you're going to start some trouble, huh?
Who you think got it in the game?
Uh-oh.
Here we go.
I mean, who would you listen to if you had to get in your car and take a ride, right?
And we want
to
hear the truth. We want to hear the truth, man, straight from the heart.
You know who I like? I like Kendrick, no doubt.
Yeah.
I like Kendrick.
Mm-hmm.
I like Jay Electronica.
That's my boy right there, too.
Right. Nice underground artist. Good. Yeah. He don't get the respect that he deserves.
That's my boy, too. He in my rotation, too, Mo.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, there's cats who been on the grind, especially out here on the West Coast, who ain't bubbled up yet, like my man Bishop Lamont.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right.
You know?
Yeah. That's folks, too. I actually met him a couple times, went to the studio and hung out with him out in Burbank. Pretty mm-hmm. cool.
That's my dudes from over there with the Mighty Aftermath. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, I don't know, man. I've been listening to, honestly, I've been on a lot of old shit.
Yeah. Right.
Getting into my soul and going back to the old shit.
Man, got to. I don't listen to none of this new shit, man. I'm going to be honest with you. You know, it put a little sourness in my stomach, you know, so that, you know, that is what it is, man. But turning the note a little bit, man, you know, I know our viewers probably don't know that, you know, Tupac is your brother. You feel me? In the whole Tupac thing. How is this situation with this film progressing with the Tupac story?
They say that it's going to get made, and they got till June. They're supposed to start in June to make it.
Uh-huh.
I was involved a little bit in the beginning. Since then, I don't know what's the deal. So we're going to wait to see.
Yeah. I was on phone the other day with Billy Bang. What you know about that? What you know about that? He said he's doing the Rider movie. How would you know about that? Any info on that?
Listen, let me tell y'all something, man.
Everybody going to say something.
A lot of everybody in the circle, you know, got a position on their experience with my brother.
Yeah.
Everybody that was there, that was around us, feel like they could do their own movie.
Gotcha.
Because of their relationship with Pop.
Yeah.
Now, whichever route it gets made through, we're going to see what happens. You know, but I feel like I got a movie.
No, you do. You do, son. You do.
Yeah, I know. I got one.
Right.
I'm a legend in the game, so I'm not sweating it.
Mm-hmm.
If I had the paper to do it myself, I would.
Exactly. Well, on you that know, note, what things do you have in the works for yourself?
Well, right now we're working on a Thug Life doc. Thug Life documentary.
Wow.
20 years later.
Man.
We was trying to get exactly on 20 years, but we couldn't finish in time. We still looking for funding, but we have started filming. You know, it's going to be dope. We got, you know, just shot Carl Kanai.
Uh-huh.
Got my OG homie, Shorty B, from Dangerous Crew.
Yeah.
We're going to get Spice One on there. We got Mac Psych, you know.
Cool.
So
it's the Bay.
Gonna be dope.
Shout out to the Yay.
Got to remember the Bay.
Yes, sir.
Man, that's beautiful.
Grapevine told me you got something going on with BET. What's up with that?
Well, you know what I'm saying? You know, I got to keep it moving and shaking. Like on that other subject that we was talking about, we got to adapt and overcome. And my way of adapting and overcoming is to blend over into film and television.
Yes,
so I've been trying to do a lot of film and television. Y'all done seen me on a lot of documentaries and shit. So I know the game now. I got the game. Now I'm trying to, you know, exercise it.
That's
now,
what it's about.
Now, before you go, Preem, let me ask you one last question. Based on, you know, Tupac being your brother and having so much experience in this rap game, what would you like to see rap go, or where would you like to see hip-hop go for the future?
For the future, there's a direct line of what we should be doing.
Mm-hmm.
Eric Garner, Michael Brown, mm-hmm. Trayvon, that shit that's been happening to young black males
mm-hmm.
in this hip-hop game, which is created by young black males, a lot of the hip-hop industry is not addressing nothing that's going on
mm-hmm.
in the community. That's
yes,
the difference
sir.
With Pac and, you know, certain
yes,
artists
sir.
Back in the days. Mm-hmm. We was addressing shit. We would be
yes,
talking
sir.
About it.
Yes, sir.
I ain't heard one record.
Nah.
You know what I mean? Nah.
Underground, you got to go on the internet, not mainstream. You
exactly.
won't hear nothing
not
like
mainstream.
That.
Nah. No, because that's not what they're pushing.
But I got a slogan that says, the future is the past. So that's pretty much what's going to have to happen.
Yeah, Thug Life, man. We've been talking about this shit 25 years. Pac was talking about this shit 20 years ago.
Yes, sir. And Brenda still having babies.
You did? So, you know, cops give a damn about a Negro, pull a trigger, kill a nigga. He's a hero.
Yes, sir.
You know, you know, so that's what I would like to see.
Right.
You know what I mean?
All right, well, we appreciate your time, Mo. You know how
man.
We do.
We're
going to link up. I'm going to holler at you, you know.
Yeah, Mo Preem, a pleasure being on the show. We
thank
really
you, man.
Appreciate
it. And much success to everything
brother.
You're doing, too, bro.
Are y'all going to play my shit?
Oh man, we going
to
man, we definitely going to spin
sir.
Your shit, man.
Yeah,
that's what we do up in here, man. S&E Live with Mars and Marv, man. We'll be right back at you.
Coming.
The station with the
best
music. Best music.
I love the music.
Love the music.
Best music.
I want to meet the man who whooped your ass. I want to meet who whooped Shad's
in your
ass.
Face.
That's what
let's do it. Let's do it.
Turn it up.
Report.
Which one is yours?
Atlanta 911-45-666-4CH for the emergency.
Yes, I need a, please, oh, ma'am, get your key. I need the police up at the W Hotel in Midtown at 188 14th Street.
188, what's the street name?
It's up here. My name is Adam James.
Adam, what's your phone number?
My phone number is...
Can you say this is 188 14th Street?
Uh-huh.
Okay, and tell me what's going on there.
They're having a fight in the bar here. We have a group that's fighting in the bar, and they're not leaving.
Does anybody have any weapons?
No weapons.
Okay, they're fighting now?
They use one of the glasses at our bar as a weapon, though. They hit somebody and cut them in the face.
Okay, this is at Collins Square?
No, yeah, Collins Square.
How many people are in the dispute? How many people are fighting?
It's got to be like 8 or 10 people.
And they're in the bar?
Yeah.
Okay, we got the call. We'll go ahead and get someone out there.
Okay, thank you.
Uh-huh.
Y'all want to try again, huh? So y'all going to try again? That's what we're going to do. We're going to try one more time. One more time, one more try, one more try. That's, we got one more try. I mean, y'all can try all y'all want, but that's what we got. I mean, I don't know what to tell you. I just thank you. I mean, I don't know. I just,
I'm trying to talk about the celebration dance at Camp Chancellor's
Battled,
especially with the pressure they were bringing up front in the third quarter to really break through with the run defense.
I'm thankful.
Talk about your performance in the second half, the big run.
I'm thankful.
Marshawn, can you tell us a little bit about the team approach?
I'm thankful.
When's your next charity event?
I'm thankful.
What was the song of the day on the way to the game, Marshawn?
I'm thankful.
Thank you.
In the mix.
Yeah, nigga, drop the top back on your back, motherfucking ride. This how we do on the West Coast, baby. Rollin' down a 405, getting high, white boys, then they wreck their shit to check my ride. I ain't being bootsy, cruising in a 6-0 Impala, driving like I'm in a hoopty. A car full of baller cats, keep your hand on the strap and take all the scratch. Niggas know my steelo, all legit, but I'm draped like a nigga moving kilos. Shit don't stop, cause I can make the ass drop and make the front pop and hit the three-wheel motion. All day, hit the freeway, take it easy, let's slide, pick up some hoop cheese, ride, rap back to the movies, high, talking back to the screen, drinking liquor, having big dreams of getting richer, I'm living that thug life, y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do,
stay true,
yeah, thug life, y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do,
stay true,
thug life, y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do,
stay true,
yeah, thug life, y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do,
stay true,
big stretch, represent the real nigga, flex, live squad and this motherfucker catch wreck. Thug life, sharp as a rough knife, shaking the dice, we roll on ghosts, we're nothing nice, so the vice wanna follow us around, razor, got them running like we clown through the town of blazer, another one, had to throw another gun, don't need another case, you can see it on my face, son, but I ain't falling yet, and I gotta give a shout to my ball, and said, MoPreme, tell him why the hoes dream, getting high off a nigga like a dope fiend, cause I'm non-stop and I'm always hustling, 24-7, ain't nothing proper when a young G's flipping keys for a living, trying to make a meal off the time that I'm giving, driven mad, I'm crazy, can't nobody fade me, and I've been going insane lately, and everybody trying to hold me back, I'm about to snap, you better move back, you know a little thug life, y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do,
stay true,
thug life, y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do,
stay true,
thug life, y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do,
stay true,
thug life, y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do. Man, I don't worry about the 5-0. If they start, cause it's all about survival. So stay smart, keep your mind on your bankroll. Always stay ahead of these stank holes. These days it's an all-out rat race. And look at me, just caught another cat case. That makes three, my lawyer's getting cash up the ass.
thug life. Y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do.
Stay true.
Thug life. Y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do.
Stay true.
Thug life. Y'all know the rules, gotta do what you gotta do. Stay true.
Word up. Well, welcome to our show.
Rental discretion is advised.
Are you scared?
Streaming live for you at rmconair.com. It's SNE Live.
It's SNE Live.
And it goes a little something like this.
Yeah. Just wrapping up the day. NBA All-Star Weekend was pretty sick. Russell Westbrook took the MVP. Steph Curry showed out. LeBron did his thing as always, you know. Steph Curry showed out in the three-point contest, taking home the trophy for that.
Don't forget Zach LaVine. Dunk contest.
Zach LaVine.
Ball.
How can I forget him? Dude was amazing with it. Like, looked like a little Vince Carter out there.
Baby Vince.
Crazy. In other news, Johnny Football in rehab. What's going on with that? Come on, man.
Cocaine's a hell of a drug.
Josh Gordon suspended for the whole year.
Cocaine's a hell of a drug.
Come on, man. You gotta be kidding me, right? Kobe's out for the season. Poor Kobe. I feel sorry for Kobe at this point. I mean, you can't be mad at somebody but for so long. Even Kobe haters got to start loving Kobe right now. I mean, it's just getting kind of bad with that.
Great
bad luck, bad luck, bad luck. More and more bad. He did a great interview, though. You know, he kind of opened up a little bit, though.
Kobe's been giving great interviews as his career winds down. Well, he's staring down Father Time.
And listen, hey, and he's renting fucking helicopters for Valentine's Day. So, hey, yeah, it all works, right?
Yeah. You wasn't with me shooting in the gym.
We lost one. Charlie Sifford, our first PGA Tour African-American winner.
Rest in peace. Golf legend. No Tiger Woods, no other black golfers before him.
Yes, sir.
More impactful.
Yes, sir. How about the Cash Money Young Money lawsuit?
Wow.
It had to happen eventually.
And how about, it was Grammy weekend, getting a pump at Nicki Minaj's party, right?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
They told him, hit the dough, baby.
Yeah, what was up with that? Like,
business is business. Walking, huh? Wayne taking Drake and Nicki. You better bet the house on that. You keep Young Thug, Birdman. Go ahead now.
Well, it is what it is, you know.
And that's unfortunate, man. Business is, you know, business ruins everything, man. It ruined Ike and Tina, man, Damon Dash and Jay-Z, now Lil Wayne and
Shaq and Kobe.
Shaq and Kobe, man. Come on, man. Come
Jen
on.
And Jen.
Man, why can't nobody stay together? Can't we all just get along, man?
Well, that's kind of why Westbrook had. He had something to say over the weekend, too. Let's get into that. Some of these athletes is having a problem with the media. You know, it's a lot of stuff going on. Durant came out and was anti-media over the weekend.
Well,
you know?
Durant rightfully so defended his coach. And what's going on right now is there's a media witch hunt going on for Scott Brooks in Oklahoma City, especially with the local media.
Yeah.
And a reporter asked Kevin Durant, you know, a sideways question about, you know, his coach's future. And to his credit, he stood up for the man and told him what time it is. Y'all don't know shit. How about that? You don't know a damn thing.
That's
all y'all
right.
do is run your mouth, dig for dirt until you make something up and create something.
Pretty
then we
much.
Got a problem.
Pretty
you know
much.
What I'm saying? I think Scott Brooks is a great coach. They've been to the conference finals. They've been to the NBA finals. They haven't won. But you got to understand, Kevin Durant's only 26 years old, brother. I mean, he got time, man. Stay with the same coach. Don't be switching up consistency. Look who Tim Duncan had his whole career. One
Tim
coach.
Duncan.
One coach.
Let's not talk about Duncan Hines.
No.
Old man really, Rivers had really a dunk in the game.
Hey, don't be hating on.
I really don't need you to talk and bring up Duncan Hines. Like, he's the focal point of the NBA, man. I mean, come on.
He's the best player on the reigning defending.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh,
reigning defending
God.
Championship.
He probably,
San Antonio Spurs.
He probably cried for half of them.
Okay, well, hey, how about that? Five. He got the thumb ring. He working on the next hand, okay? So y'all can say what y'all want about my man, Duncan, but you know what? He's having the last laugh. Don't trip. Spurs
and you said
again.
It yourself, no Duncan. How can you be that tall and not dunk?
Oh, no, he got his last
night. He lays up everything.
No, he can boom. You didn't see last night? He boomed on him. One last time. He got one more boom.
Oh, well, we didn't see him in the dunk contest this All-Star weekend.
Speaking of that, we didn't see LeBron either, and he's finally coming out saying, that he feels like, you know, he thinks he should have. It's years later. You're pretty old. Well, why are you going to say that now? You might as well have to rode out how you rode out.
And that's why LeBron's not even in my top 10. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Like, if y'all want to go there,
one game.
No. It's not one game.
What the greats do.
Exactly. It's his basketball personality. Yes, you 6'9", 260, whatever, muscles coming out of your eyebrows. Yeah, you could run a pass, jump better than anybody ever of all time that ever touched a basketball. But at the end of the day, you can't score like Jordan. You ain't got his heart. And you be doing dumb shit, like not even doing the NBA dunk.
Hey, man, are y'all getting comp from the Miami Heat, man?
No.
Yeah, y'all ain't tell me about.
I'm getting no checks.
Y'all getting some? I think y'all getting checks from the Miami Heat.
Chris Bosh, where's my money?
I'm actually not mad at LeBron. I have him up there. I don't know. I'm not gonna do an order because I'm a little, you know, dated than some of you people, and my list may be a little longer when it comes to just 10 players.
My 10.
But I give him his credit. I think that he lived up to the hype. Nobody came out more hyped than him.
Do the dunk contest,
but
man.
I think the pressure made him not want to do that. If he probably figured, if I don't win this, I'm not. But look,
it would go down in history as lame.
Do you think people thought that when they went up against Dr. J, or when they went up against Vince Carter, or
Michael Jordan was thinking?
Is y'all trying to say he's soft?
I think his minerals wasn't where they should be when it comes to that slam dunk contest.
I think that he just had competition. He just knew that he wasn't going to win.
Probably.
Absolutely.
But he would have won. He's LeBron.
How could you not win? You're LeBron James. Yeah. You damn sure better win. Yeah. That's all I know. Man, come on, bro.
You got Big O in a competition, man.
But yeah, well.
Look, man, the only pass I give him is this. Up until this year, there wasn't a lot of competition. I could see if the best players were still. The best players don't really do the dunk contest no more. So if would we give him props if he beat some dude that we had never heard of, if he beat, you know, Gerald Green or somebody
or
else?
Let's say if he lose to somebody.
Or lose to somebody else, right?
Then what would happen?
Well, listen, bringing up the dunk contest topic, we were going to have Derek Winberg on here, which we're going to have on next week. Derek Winberg of NC State, coach of NC State.
Wolfpack,
absolutely. And he's doing the Dominique Wilkins documentary.
Dominique and Jordan, that was the best dunk contest ever.
And listen, people and fans don't even know that Dominique Wilkins won
the first one.
Yes, sir.
Absolutely. Sure.
They say they should have won a second.
He should have won a second.
He got beat by 2 points. It was 47-45, and Jordan went home with that. And because only the dunk contest was located in Chicago.
Then Dominique was out there balling this weekend. Man. People didn't see that. He was out there hitting half-court shots.
Dominique is still a cross-up half to lose.
A little heavier than normal.
I'd suit Dominique up in a closer role if I could. You know, the last 2 minutes of the game, just come in and handle up for it. They should start doing that like baseball players. You know, bring in old school. Mike can give you 2 minutes. Man. Tell me Mike can't give you 2 minutes at the end of the fourth quarter.
He's still looking good, though, man. I had the pleasure of meeting him on the ESPYs red carpet, man, 2014, man. It was a good pleasure, man. He's still looking good.
On another note, do anybody got a Bobby Christina update?
Word is, last update that I saw, her organs, they're claiming, are shutting down. They're claiming it's a matter of time. But we're just going to pray for her because at the end of the day, there's no better doctor than the good Lord. And we're just going to hope that he just shines some sort of positivity on her. And hopefully she'll pull through. And if she doesn't, we're still going to be praying for the family, the Houston and the Brown family.
Yes.
And let's get a moment of silence. For Bobby Christina, man. Shouts out to Bobby Christina, man. Hope you pull through. We pulling for you over here at S&E Live with Mars and Marv, man, and Shaft. And, man, we really genuinely think that you're going to pull through.
God is a miracle worker.
Absolutely.
Yes, sir. Amazing things can happen.
Yes, sir. We'd like to thank our guest, MoPreme, today.
Yes, we would. Thank you, MoPreme. Make sure you guys find him at MoPreme Shakur on Twitter. That's at MoPreme. On his Twitter handle. We appreciate the love.
We'd like to thank Chris the Engineer, our boy, man. He's our creative director, always keeping us down and around. We'd like to thank our producers, Terrence Meeks, and also Tyson Michael Eli Pearson. Also,
looking forward to the NWA movie again, you know, recapping that. And I like I said again, I just want to see. I want to see what role everybody played. What did Easy really play? What role did he play? What about Ren? We ain't heard of him in so long. You know, they're going to have to start talking about a lot of things and a lot of people. Yella, it's a lot of things that nobody know about that you know, I'm looking forward to hearing about.
I'm excited to see, but I'm red boxing it because I don't want to get shot in the theater.
We here live, man, every Monday from 5 to 6, S&E Live with Roscoe Media Center, S&E Live with Mars and Marv, and a Shaft Report. You better understand it, man.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's going down.
Bring the action.
And now, here's what's trending.
Trending.
Here's what's trending.